Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a LEGO Mars mission set. This is the MX-81 Hypersonic Operations Aircraft. It came out in 2008 with 795 pieces, and it includes three regular minifigures and two aliens that we'll look at more closely later in the video. Now, this is a very large craft here with a very large name, but rather than making this a very large video, I'm gonna try something different. You can let me know how it works out. I'm gonna get right into it and just talk about all of the features and just get right through them, because ultimately this is just a big old spacecraft. But yes, it is quite large, isn't it? The wing of the thing is one of those large cargo or passenger plane wings that LEGO has made, and here they've done it in white compared to the normal light gray color that they use for most of the uses. As with all of the Mars mission sets, this one does have quite a large number of stickers that are pretty important for the look, you know, getting the level of detail in there. This thing is absolutely bristling with all sorts of things that look like weapons on the front. I think that they're laser cannons, all the long barrels with the transparent blue at the end. You can choose to see them as some sort of sensors or as just lights if you want to, but I really think they're supposed to be weapons. You notice around the back, things look a little bit odd, maybe a little bit awkward there. Well, you can see there's a little bay for holding a vehicle, but just the shape back here is unusual for LEGO aircraft and ships. What they've got going on here is an internal small little mechanism where you push down on this button, it's going to release a latch. It's going to unlock something, which is going to allow this to happen. So you can actually drop that section down, and now the whole ship can actually be just left there. It's actually just standing up on top of that. So that's something that's intended to happen when you're in the air. So you can actually drop off the little surface rover from the air, just drop that down so you don't have to come in for a full landing. Bring down these small little ramps and then just let that guy drive on out. Presumably you'd have a minifigure in it. It's a decent sized vehicle for a small rover to drop, and you see it's got a drill bit on the front. So this could be used for some small scale mining operations, or it could be used for large scale prospecting. And you can see it has no prints or stickers on it, but they just try to simulate a little bit of a console section there with the orange grill piece. And I do very much like this shape of wheels. Getting back to the ship, as is normal for LEGO, there are more things that you can remove from a ship of this size. For one thing, you can remove these two side pods and use them as individual small ships. Now, this is a little bit awkward with the one long, you know, extra boom here on the side, but what you can do to make that a little bit more balanced is you can take off the one from the other side, place that onto here. Now you have one ship that has the full accoutrement with, if I can ever get these pins in there, there we go. So this one has the full set of lasers that are sticking out, just bristling all over it. And I think that looks really good just by itself. And then you have one that's just smaller, just a smaller scout ship. You can bring these little side bits down and little winglets. You know, it's based upon the same center section, but looks very different. Or if you want to, you could just leave the big lasers behind on the ground, or you could even reattach them here in the center and just have no cockpit on the main section, and then have two of the exact same thing flying around. So here's what this one looks like up close with a little dude in it. It is a little bit awkward to have those tan Technic pins sticking out to the side. It would have been nicer to have those done in black, but I think they wanted them to have a little bit of contrast, just to make it a little bit easier for the youngest of kids to see them and to line them up when it's time to connect everything. Nice little, power cell engine, something related to propulsion back there. A little detailing, a little bit of greebling and stuff. And I always, always appreciate it when they allow you to change the angles of wings however you want, although I wish they could have made it so that you could also angle them down. A couple stickers up here on the top, one sticker on the front. To get into the cockpit area, you have to remove this entire top piece, which is actually pretty easy and simple. And inside of there, you see, has one nice little console, and each of them has one of these, and it's a nice little sticker with a very bright color scheme. Really stands out even against a lot of light. From what's left over, you now have a small little little probe, little satellite assembly that you can launch, and then it would just kind of spin like that. It would look pretty good. Here's a closer look at some of the larger stickers on some of the larger pieces on what's left over, including a couple of pieces that are connected up here. And these two together are hinged and they can be turned up, which then leaves you with another piece here that you turn down for what? For the lab section. So there you've got another nice high visibility sticker on a console piece that's showing some data that's being collected from a sample. This is some sort of machine back here, some sort of spectral imaging machine or something that's going to be, you know, looking at the resonance, possibly something related to trying to find out what elements are in a sample. So you would actually open this up, put a sample inside of there, close it down, and then actually be able to process it. Got one little minifigure accessory holder on this side, one over on this side that right now just has a pair of binoculars, and they've also got another little sample container down here. Wow, that's pretty bright. Imagine putting a UV light on that. It would just light way up. One sticker up on the top there, and this is going to open up and have a couple of the energy crystals that you're trying to go after with all of the mining efforts in Mars mission. Farther back behind there, you can also see that a couple of those crystals are currently being utilized, it looks like. I think that those are actually being used to power this ship right now. So you could also kind of get in there and replace those if you want to imagine that they've been kind of depleted over time. Two last things on the major section of this ship here. First of all, you've got a large Technic competition cannon set over here. So that's a real projectile launcher that will allow you to really shoot with this ship. And then over on this side, you've got a little tube, which is able to contain a little sled thing, which can also hold one of the aliens in it. So this is able to be shifted around. It's kind of using the same idea as their tube-based transportation system, and it's got a little sticker up on the top of it that just lets you know that this has potentially dangerous material or a dangerous specimen inside if you've actually captured one. Now, one last thing, with a ship of this size and with so many things sticking out from it, it could be difficult to move this around and to handle it, but it's not, because they put a handle on it. This back here. The handle, so you just pick it up right there and then you can actually swish this giant thing. It's pretty sturdy in there, so that's a good bit of design there to actually allow a kid to fly around something of this giant size. Now here's the alien ship that's included with this set, just to provide a little bit of extra conflict, I guess, and tension to the whole setting. And this is much smaller than the human ship, but it's still not as small as a lot of the ships are that are included as kind of the extra, you know, the other side in a set. So this is pretty respectable in size. Just see in comparison to a regular minifig there, you know, that's pretty decent, and it looks really nice. I really love the design of this. It's very alien, it's very unusual. They didn't go with just the standard stereotypical shapes of things and arrangements of things, and I like those stickers that have that kind of holographic effect. So they give you the little rainbows going through there, and you've got your kind of engine sections back here on the back. This looks like it'd be a very powerful fighter. I like its angles. I like a lot about this. I think it's very nicely done. The cockpit section is interesting. There's not anything actually in there. However, this is intended to be flown by one of the commander units, and to get it to sit in there, because these don't have any studs or receptacles for studs on their legs, they have you put an ExoForce hand, a little clip piece there, and then you actually clip this guy to the back, like so. Oops, actually accidentally took that out, but you clip him in there, and there we go. Now he's in place, and now he's not gonna fall out. So it allows him to sit, even though he's not really set up to sit. So here's the assortment of figures included with this set, and that includes, over on the left, myself, because of course the minifigure version of me would be involved in a series as cool as this, even though I personally wasn't, my minifigure still was. Another very common face on that center dude, but then the one on the right is very different, and
I appreciate that. I like the fact that they included one dude who's just not normal, who's not the stereotypical confident, you know, hero-faced dude for going out into space. It's a little bit something different. You know, I like that. It's risky. It's not normal, but I appreciate that it's not normal. You know, it's good to kind of toss things up a little bit. And then here are your two aliens, just a regular citizen over here, which is not much of a figure, really. It's articulated at the waist, so it can bend up and down, but that's just all there is to it, really. Interestingly enough, this one does have a little bit, just a tiny bit, of glow-in-the-dark material in the center of it, but it doesn't really work very well. You have to charge it up with a super bright light, and then it just glows so dimly that I can't even show it on camera. It's just too dim to even capture. The commander figure is much more interesting looking. He uses two different colors of plastic, plus he has the different colors of eyes, which actually comes from using a 1x1 cylinder piece. He uses the same mold for his arms and his legs. They're just upside down, so his legs are upside down arms, or vice versa. And you could change out the cylinder up there if you wanted to give him some different eye color or something. And you can see it's got the one peg hole on the back to allow you to connect something there. And the little citizen also has a peg-sized hole as well. And here's just a look at the backs of the human torsos. So I guess I wasn't able to get through that quickly after all, because there's just so much to this thing. I think it looks really good from most angles, not so much from the back corners and the rear of it. That is an awkward looking section towards the rear, just for holding the little surface rover driller vehicle. I wish they could have enclosed that a little bit more. But other than that, I very much like the overall design. I really appreciate that you can hold the entire thing from a single handle. It's always good to have additional ships that you can break off from a large ship for more kids to play with, and it just really expands the possibilities for imaginative play. And I very much like that little alien craft. It's just very creative. So that's it for my look at this set. Feel free to share your thoughts in a comment down below, and stick around to check out more of my videos, because more are on the way very soon. Catch you later.